I want to show you what it's like to be mentally drained when you have schizophrenia. Welcome to Surviving Schizophrenia. My name is Steven. I hope you're having a wonderful day. So for the last day or so, I've been getting consistently more drained and tired. I want to talk about why and how that feels and what I do about it. So as far as physically, 2 days ago, or 3 days ago, I guess, I was feeling great, mentally as well, and I went for over a 5 mile walk and I was feeling amazing. The next day, I felt even better. Just went for over a 6 mile walk, which is a record for me. Then yesterday, I took it off. I was feeling tired, was a bit sore, wanted to rest up for today so I could record a video and maybe go for some exercise too. And that's kind of when things I started getting really tired. I woke up this morning around 11 o'clock, which is usual for me. Actually, sometimes I do wake up slightly earlier, but 11 o'clock, and I was exhausted, not just physically, but also mentally now too. That said, I still wanted to work. I wanted to record a video because I love making these videos. So I went out and I tried to record a video out by the ocean. I was going to do a walk, and I was going to talk about, how I felt, and then some other subjects as well, that I will still make a video on in the future, specifically whether or not I have autism, and my history with schizophrenia, and my illness, and all of that kind of stuff, leading up to when I felt ill, my childhood, all that. I'll still do that in the future, for sure. But I couldn't record it, really. I started and stopped about 5 or 6 times, and then I just went for it, and I wasn't happy with how it turned out, so I stopped about 9.5 minutes into it. I was just too tired and drained, and I really wanted to record today, which is why I'm doing it now, but it's not easy when you're feeling mentally and physically drained. I mean, it's easier to talk about my feeling mentally and physically drained, but not much else. And I was getting my words jumbled and losing my train of thought continuously on that video, which is why I stopped recording it. And that's why I'm recording this now. So it's not like I'm feeling really stressed out, for example, when I am physically and mentally drained, though I can be, I guess. Right now I'm not. I'm in a good mood, you can probably tell, but when I am mentally and physically drained, especially mentally though, it makes everything harder, and sometimes I do get a little cranky, I think, and a little on edge and stressed and anxious, which when that does happen, I get depressed usually as well. It all kind of comes crumbling down. So what I try to do to avoid that is, relax. I'm not doing that right now, but I wanted to show you what it was like, so that's why I'm doing this. But I go and I take it easy. I have a comfort food snack or something, and I mean, not too much, because I'm trying to watch my weight too, but I go and I watch a show, a comedy. I relax. I play a relaxing game or something like that. I like video games, so that's my way of coping. So I find that helps a lot until I rest up, however long that takes. Until I'm back to my usual self. In the past, it has taken a while. Sometimes a few weeks, even. But more recently, I usually bounce back, I'd say, within a few days to a week, at most. As long as I am taking that time to watch my mental health and relax and take it easy. Because it's easy to get overly stressed out when I am feeling this drained mentally and physically. And I think also, as far as the physical side of that goes too, I can't say I've done this a lot in the past, but I should try to, I know, still try and exercise a little bit at least, go for a short walk, something like that, because then, I mean, if you don't exercise for a while, that will affect your physical and mental health, and I think it's important for me to try to remember to keep that up even when I am feeling drained. Sure, I don't have to go as long, but I should try to do something to stay physically fit as well when I am feeling drained, because then that'll help me bounce back faster as opposed to just sitting for a week on end, maybe, which is not good, and I'm trying to work on that too. And as for why I am so mentally drained right now, I'm not entirely sure. I think it's due to my schizophrenia for sure, but I don't have a specific reason. I was feeling great a few days ago, even 2 days ago, and I've been sleeping really well. Well, actually, to be fair, I wasn't sleeping that well a few days ago. I have a Google Nest that I used to play white noise, and that was popping. Or making a popping noise. And that was affecting my sleep. Well, I'm thinking about this now. I have been sleeping better, even without the white noise, I've noticed. Though it takes me a little longer to go to sleep. But without the white noise, I don't know, I have been sleeping better without the white noise, so I don't know if it's necessarily not having white noise to fall asleep to that could have caused anything. I'm not sure. I just realized that right now. That's the one thing that has changed, is that I stopped using my Google Nest for white noise because it was making a weird popping noise, so I put it aside. But I think I have been sleeping better, so honestly, I'm not sure exactly why I feel this mentally and physically drained right now. However, this has happened in the past, and it's not a common thing necessarily anymore. I believe it was way more common when I was more ill. A few years ago, even, from 2012, really. So I'm not entirely sure why I feel like this, but I actually am not sure. I think it's just something to do with my schizophrenia. I have really no exact clue. I don't know how else to explain it, but I don't know, that's one of the things about schizophrenia, you can't always explain it, even though I'm trying here. I do feel a little anxious, but I can't say that's necessarily the reason why I was feeling mentally and physically worn out. However, being like this, in this kind of state, it does stress me out a bit. It makes me feel a little anxious, because it's just like an overlay that I've on top of everything else that just kind of stresses me out even more than usual having this. It's not affecting my mood too much right now, but it is causing me some anxiety, I guess, now that I think about it. And when I woke up this morning, I mean, I felt tired, but I also know I looked tired too in the mirror. More tired than usual, sure, I was still waking up, but even after my espresso, my coffee in the morning, usually that wakes me up somewhat, but today it didn't really. It kind of didn't faze me. I don't know, I guess I was just that tired, maybe out of it. So usually I am able to wake up with an espresso in the morning, but not today. For some reason. And living with schizophrenia, you know, it's not like a flat plane in terms of how you feel. It definitely dips and kind of goes up and down a bit. It tends to be down more than up for me, but some days are better than others, and some days, you know, I'm just not doing well for whatever reason. Whether it's me feeling mentally and physically drained or stressed out for really no good reason or depressed some days, I'm thinking about the past. It's one of the things I've learned to live with schizophrenia is that, you know what, some days just won't be good. But you know what? At the same time, other days will be great. So I've come to realize that over the years, and I know in my mind, I just acknowledge, you know, today's not a great day. So like I said earlier, I go to my coping strategy kind of things, you know, I go watch some comedies, play some games, take it easy, relax. Because I know there'll be better days ahead. I just have to get through these rough days that are going on right now. Just easier said than done. For sure, but I know for me, those good days have been happening more often now. And I just have to try to get through the rough days to get back to the good days again. And emotion-wise, actually let me go in general here now for how I feel in general every day with schizophrenia. I don't really get angry that easily or often. I think there might be a misconception about schizophrenia is that we can be more aggressive, for example. For me, that's not the case. I don't get angry easily. However, I do get stressed out easily. There's a difference there. So, like, right now I'm not angry, but I am still anxious. So, for example, I have trouble being around people when they're eating, because of the noise it makes when people are chewing, but also the noise of, like, their fork hitting their plate. So my parents, I haven't been able to eat with them the better part of a decade now, really. Unless there's a special occasion, I can try to deal with it for that time. But for example, I have to shut all the doors between us and put on my earbuds sometimes to play noise and cancel out other noise. So if I hear my parents, like, what I call clinking, which is like that ceramic plate and fork hitting plate, that'll get me stressed out. I don't get angry, but I do get anxious. I go like, dang it. That's not anger there, but that's like, dang, I hear it. Ugh. Okay, go put on my earbuds. Earbuds. Okay. And then I kind of forget about it a little bit after. So, actually, I could see how that looks like anger, but for me, it's not anger, it's just anxiety. And, like, even right now, I'm not feeling great. I am definitely very. I'm losing my train of thought now, too, but yeah, I'm feeling really worn out. And so, I'm not angry or anything. I'm not angry about being like feeling like this. I'm not angry at anyone else. I am just a little stressed, but it doesn't necessarily affect my mood either. It's kind of complicated. So, as far as emotions go, I'm not really angry often, and even feeling like this doesn't make me, sure, it makes me a little more anxious, but it doesn't make me angry, it doesn't make me really sad. And I think in the past it would have made me really sad, actually. But in now it doesn't affect my mood like that as much, or my emotions either. And I think that's because I'm recovering. Simple as that. I've really recovered a lot over the last decade, since 2012 when I really felt ill. But, and I said this before, having this channel has been very cathartic talking about it. It's been amazing having all your comments and your support. And that has drastically affected my health in a positive way. It's made me feel proud of myself and confident and up more upbeat, and I think that's why I've just been recovering more, and that's why this isn't as big an issue anymore. So when I'm not feeling well and I'm anxious and I'm tired, or maybe I'm depressed, there's a few things that I do. First, I recognize it, you know. I acknowledge I'm feeling anxious or I'm feeling stressed or depressed. And then, once I've acknowledged it, I tell someone. I tell my parents. So they know that I'm not feeling well, so they can help me there. They can either give me more space, or they can help me get some anxiety medication, whatever it may be, or just so that they know that I'm not doing well. And then I turn to my coping strategies, and I go do something that relaxes me, that takes my mind off it, that allows me to work through it, whatever that is, whether that's going for a walk, short walk or a long walk, depending on how I feel, whether that's watching a comedy TV show or drawing or playing a game. And through that usually helps me get back to my normal state. Can't say necessarily quickly, but by doing those steps and that kind of activity resilience menu kind of thing, that works for me. And that's how I go from feeling anxious or stressed or depressed or whatever it may be to working through it and coming back on the other side, back to myself again, my usual self, in a good mood. Yeah. So, I hope you enjoyed this video of me sharing what it's like and showing what it's like to be mentally drained, physically drained, tired, and explaining my emotions and what I do when I'm like this. And if you did enjoy it, please leave a like and maybe subscribe. Love to have you here. And I hope you all have a happy and healthy rest of your day. And I hope to see you in the next video.